Well, in another instance of play stupid games, win stupid prizes, the country of Mexico announced this week that they are officially cutting off the state of Texas and instead will now be using New Mexico as their number one port for bringing goods into the United States. Cutting off the state of Texas of billions upon billions of dollars in yearly revenue. This was announced by Mexico's economy minister this week after she said, quote, "We can't leave all the eggs in one basket and be hostages to someone who wants to use trade as a political tool." And of course, this is referring to Republican Texas Governor Greg Abbott's recent 10-day border stunt, where he decided to expand the inspections of all those trucks coming from Mexico into the state of Texas to intentionally disrupt the supply chain, which, by the way, did cost Texas $4.2 billion in 10 days. But he wanted to slow down the flow of goods and other products into the United States, manufacturing equipment, stuff that was going outside of the state of Texas, because it would create shortages that would drive up inflation that would make Biden look bad. That is why Greg Abbott did that. It was a big, ha-ha, I got you to the Biden administration by intentionally disrupting the supply chain. But in the end, Mexico's having the last laugh now, aren't they? Because during that slowdown, they ended up rerouting some of those trucks through New Mexico, through a port over there. And now this week they say, you know what? That actually went so well over here. We're moving it all over there permanently. Permanently. So Texas, as I mentioned, is going to lose billions of dollars every year now forever. That is money that is officially gone and not coming back to the state of Texas. And because there's going to be fewer goods and services coming through Texas now, people are going to lose their jobs. Local economies will take a hit. You know, it's that ripple effect throughout the economy. Suddenly you got 100 people in your city that lose their jobs. That's 100 people that are no longer going to eat at the local diner because they can't afford it. Local diner starts losing money. Their employees can no longer go out, go down to the little boutique down the street and buy clothes. So the boutique takes a hit and so on and so forth, rippling all the way through the economy, all because Greg Abbott wanted to stick it to President Biden. Mexico is having the last laugh now, Greg. And I hope your voters understand that as they head to the polls this year. That trade, these trucks, they're not coming back through your state, Texans. And you depend on them for your economic activity. Maybe not all of it, but a decent-sized portion of it is now gone forever because Greg Abbott decided to use trade as a political tool. And now he's the one who looks like a political tool. Thanks for watching. And if you like what you saw, don't forget to like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our Ring of Fire channel here.